wish I could. I could have said goodbye. I would have said what I wanted to. Maybe even cried for you. If I knew it would be the last time, I would have broke my heart in two, trying to save a part of you. Don't wanna feel another touch. Don't wanna start another fire. Don't wanna know another kiss. No other name falling off my lips. Don't wanna give my heart away to another stranger, or let another day begin. Won't even let the sun. When we first met, I never thought that I would fall. I never thought that I'd find myself lying in your arms. And I wanna pretend that it's not true. Oh, baby, that you're gone. 'Cause my world keeps turning and turning and turning.
Of the love you have for each other. It's not just the words you speak today which will unite you, but the sense of love and devotion you feel within your hearts. A good partner in marriage will not only be loving and caring, but also a true friend. So Neil and Nikki, are you both ready to make your commitment to each other?
Yeah.
Thank you. Neil, I'm going to ask you some questions, and I'd like you to reply with those two little words I do at the end. Neil, do you take Nikki to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise not only to be her husband, but also her best friend, to be loving and faithful to her for the rest of your life?
I do.
Thank you. And Nikki, do you take Neil to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise not only to be his wife, but also his best friend, to be loving and faithful to him for the rest of your life?
I do.
I'm going to ask you to declare your freedom to marry, and then you will both exchange your marriage vows. So Neil, you're first. Please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Or any lawful impediment.
Why I, Neil Williams.
Why I, Neil Williams.
May not be joined in matrimony.
I will not be joined in matrimony.
To Nicola Jane Waters.
To Nicola Jane Waters.
Thank you. Nikki, if you can repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment. Of any lawful.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Nicola Jane Waters.
Why I, Nicola Jane Waters.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Neil Williams.
To Neil Williams.
Thank you very much. The exchange of vows forms the heart of your ceremony. Having declared that you are free to marry, the time has now come for you to make your marriage vows. This is a very special moment because if you say these words, you will be joined in marriage. Did you want to turn and face each other and hold hands? Again, your first, Neil. If you can repeat after me and say these words to your beautiful bride and groom. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Neil Williams.
To witness that I, Neil Williams.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Nicola Jane Waters.
Nicola Jane Waters.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Lovely, thank you. And Nikki, if you can repeat after me and say these words for Neil, please. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Nicola Jane Waters.
To witness that I, Nicola Jane Waters.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Neil Williams.
Neil Williams.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Fabulous, thank you. Nikki and Nia are going to exchange wedding rings today. And a wedding ring is an ancient and traditional way of sealing a marriage, as it is a circle with neither a beginning nor an end. It is an outward sign to everyone of the promises you have both made here today. So, Freddie, if you'd like to come and join us in the room. Okay, so I'm on your way. Neil, if you could take Nikki's ring and place it on the tip of the third finger of her left hand, and just hold it there while you say these words. After me, but say them to your beautiful bride. With this ring, I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
I promise to respect.
I promise to respect.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
And be faithful always.
And be faithful always.
Lovely Neil, slip that one on. Definitely not coming off when it's on. Lovely, thank you. And Nikki, if you'd like to take Neil's ring, place it on the tip of the third finger of his left hand. And again, repeat after me, but say these words to Neil. With this ring, I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
All that I am.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I promise to respect. And cherish you. And be faithful always. Lovely. Now slip that ring all the way on.
He's on. It's not coming on.
Lovely. Well, thank you very much, Freddie. I think he deserves a round of applause. Nikki and Neil, may you always be able to confide in each other, support each other's hopes and dreams, and laugh with one another. From this moment, you have created an understanding between the two of you that no one can break. We all hope that your love, trust, and understanding of each other will continue to bring you both contentment and joy in your life together and remain constant through the years. So, Neil and Nikki, you have given your marriage vows and promises to each other in front of everyone here, and it is my great pleasure to announce that you are now married. Neil, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
My heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason. Turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every hour of every day keeping you safe, and I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I need you to see that you are the reason.
I don't wanna feel no more. I don't wanna cry no more. I don't wanna cry no more. Come back, I need you.
You are the reason.
Just a little closer. Come a little closer.
I need you to hold me tonight. Climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. 'Cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
Above you. take away my sadness. Ease my troubles, that's what you do.
Just
soaking. Firstly, I'd like to say how absolutely gorgeous my beautiful wife looks this afternoon. I'd also like to mention her maid of honour and bridesmaids who look magnificent and have helped Nicky with everything. And Joe, obviously, walked her down the aisle. I'd like to say a huge thank you to those who have travelled a long way to get here today, especially my sister and her fiance who have come from Amsterdam. All that way only to find out they have to buy their own drinks. Sorry about that, but we had a budget and we spent it. We'd like to say thank you to the parents on both sides of the family. For all the contributions to the world. Without you, we'd not be here today. Or purchase our luxurious 10-seat and Wi-Fi controlled hot tub. I'm sure you will agree how stunning my wife looks today. Nothing could have prepared me for when you walked down the aisle. Thank you for marrying me and making me the proudest man in the world. I can't tell you how happy I am for you, my wife. I've had the best 6 years of my life and I look forward to spending the rest of my days with you. You're not only my wife, but my best friend. Thanks for organising the stag do and for the lovely outfits I was made to wear. I'll be squeezing into one later. Turns out Nicky likes a man in leather. Seriously though, thanks for being there for the last 40 odd years. And hopefully for another 40 more. That depends on what you have to say next. Just one more important last thing. Please all raise your glass and toast to family and friends who are no longer with us today and are sadly missed. Family and friends.
Okay, so I'll keep it short and sweet because, as you know, I like the chat. So, first things first. Oh, my best friend Lorraine, where are you? There she is. Well, where do I begin and end? Right, so 38 beautiful years I've had this one. Love her dearly. She has pulled out every stop imaginable with the help of my daughter, who is just making this happen today. And my wonderful friend, and florist, Kerry, to make it all beautiful. I want to thank each and every one of you for making the effort to come today. Mr. Lewis over there for making some amazing brownies that you'll all have the pleasure of eating later on. And I'm sure you'll be putting your orders in to say, can you make yourself? Demi, where's Dems? There she is, probably Dems, lovely baby. Had a bit of a dodgy couple of days, but we got there and it's all sorted. Everyone else that's come along, Harry, I love you, because you're just the best. You put up with me at work, being a bit of a bride dinner over the last few weeks. And my Joe for walking me down the aisle. My daughter, I mean, she's just gone, like, way beyond stuff, but I could never imagine. And most importantly, my beautiful, amazing, one-of-a-kind husbands. And I never actually thought I'd get married, I've got to be honest, this is quite a terrible thing.
I've got the divorce
point. Yeah, all, everyone that's known me for probably in the region of 20 years, Karen talked out for that, that never thought I'd actually get married. But thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I'm sure from Neil's as well, thank you all for coming. and more importantly, for our parents that have really helped us happen financially, emotionally, and everything else. The lovely girls over there as well. Thank you. Oh, I've got a couple of little gifts here. Oh, let me just see what I've got. Sorry. James, one for you. I know who that one is. Just a little something, you know, quite as much as it is.
First off, it is a privilege and an honour to be asked to be Bill and best man at their wedding. Although it didn't fill me with great confidence when he asked two of us to do one of Neil's jobs, which might explain Neil's lack of trust in what me and James are about to do, to be honest with you. As Neil and Nikki have already taken most of my speech, I'd like to thank all family and friends for making this day happen. The whole day was perfect. The entire bridal party, all bridesmaids, made words. You were fantastic and you looked absolutely stunning. The brief from Neil was very different to the brief from Dick, right? And I'll give you an idea of how much me and James knew about today in a quick summary. Neil's brief was, it's really relaxed, wear any suit tonight, and don't go into bedrooms. And then we met Nick at Blue Water and Nick said, no, you're wearing matching suits, you're wearing pink shirts. But that's a different story that I will get into after the do the speech and you better be fun. But no, in all honesty, absolutely fantastic couple, and nothing makes me proud as you stand up here. Obviously not the Neil, I would say, he's a very good friend of mine, obviously, his new wife. Nicky. So at this point, I'd like to sort of raise a glass to absent family and friends. For those that don't know, Neil lost his mum about the age of 18. We had the privilege of being around her, obviously growing up, probably most eating most of the fridge, to be fair. She was an absolutely fantastic lady, and I'm sure if she was here today, she'd be extremely proud. So please raise your glasses to Neil. Right, I'm going to hand you over to James. He's going to run you through some of the stuff.
Right. What am I wearing?
No, it's 49 clothes. So as Paul just said, we've known each other for 40 plus years, I think so. So when me and Paul sat down to write, we had a lot of memories, a lot of history, a lot of stories to get through. So, yeah, we had quite stuff, a lot of stuff to work on. So before I start, I want to make sure that everyone's got three. Everyone's sitting comfortably. Has everyone been to the toilet? We've made a couple of notes, so.
Yeah.
Sorry.
7:30, so you've got a bit more.
Well, we're going to have to cut this down. That's not a problem. We'll just get rid of some of these stories. It's fine. Right, we'll start with this one. How we met Neil. So we grew up on the mean streets of Greenock in the early 80s. We lived about 100 metres from each other, I guess?
Yes.
Yeah? Cool, funny, sporty, popular. It was all the reasons why Neil wanted to train Neil. No memories of Neil, though, from the early days. Skinny, slightly nerdy kid. Big bowl hair. Right, I know, really hard to believe. We've been friends ever since, so you could say we've been friends from White Bar to Duncan Goodwin. Anyway, we better move on. Seven. Yeah, you seven. We got seven. Alright. We'll have to start this now. Right, first story. Barry Nelson's Barney Williams. Neil shares a sausage with Colin. Right, Neil takes the centre forward.
No, that's
all. Neil's bottom problem.
Right, this might not be as what you think. Right, so obviously from the age of, what, 7, 8? Me and Neil used to like to have a little day out down Stone Lakes, doing a bit of fishing. We would have young men that when one of us left earlier, we didn't have mobile phones, we had to write in chalk at the bottom of the steps next to my house to let each other know that one of us had already gone down now. And just leave alone. So over the years, we've done a lot of fishing and spent time out in the bank, in the tent, and you get to know each other really well in the tent, do some sort of a bit of male bonding. Then one year, and then one year, Neil, I think Mark might have come to that. We went to a place called Angus Paradise. Now, I will clarify that, that is not stunning ladies holding you on the boat. It is a purpose built fishery with about 13 lakes and it's all about fishing. Now, I'm not sure what happened, really, but it's changed forever. I'm not sure what caused Neil's sudden bottom issues, but the sounds from the toilet were horrifying, and they scarred me for practically life, to be honest with you. And yeah, so after 2 days, Neil's finally ventured out of the apartment. There's a complex relationship down now. Neil was fishing the easy access lake, and that is because it was the closest one to the shallows. Me and my friends were I think it was about 1 hour of lemonade later, we saw the silhouette of Neil doing that all the way across the lake, so I guess it wasn't in the best condition. I'm not sure how many pairs of underwear went down there, but I would guess that only 50% survived and came home. And fishing with you, mate, has never, ever been the same.
Neil's gaming skills?
That's not sensible, so I've
done. Neil and his chocolate finger.
Oh!
The Manning years. Get rid of it. From Metro to Mercedes.
Right. I don't know. But Neil's self-confidence in car advice is quite different. It's well documented that he is a self-proclaimed Lewis Hamilton with the driving skills.
It's not always been plain sailing. I think he crashed into a wall once in the Metro. His inability to read the petrol gauge is something that baffles me even to this day. I remember coming back, I think we dropped James off at some point in St Albans years ago, and we ran out of petrol on the M25, not too far from Dartford Bridge. He opted out, he said, don't worry, I'll find my dad. Now, I'm not sure how that conversation went with Mark, But about 2 hours later, I was in the back of one of Essex's finest highway patrol cars with a jerry can trying to get £3 worth of petrol to Nimper's own. But yeah, so that obviously didn't go to plan. Anyone else whose car ever broke down and was stuck in reverse, they'd leave it. Nah, not Neil. Neil would drive it home about 2 miles backwards. But he was too stubborn to actually admit that his car wasn't maybe in the best of conditions. So four wheels, Neil's, I'm not going to lie, pretty garbage. Two wheels, even worse. We went to Iron Appa about, maybe 20 odd years ago. As you do, lads on the hollowed out melons, make crash helmets of them, and whatever else, and we hired out mopeds. And no word of a lie, within 2 minutes, Neil was literally up a tree, not into a tree, up a tree, with a moped. But Neil's like famous phrase with cars is Neil knows best. If he ever gives you any advice about buying a car, please ignore it, okay? Go to completely the opposite of what he says, and you'll be perfectly fine getting up. Right?
So, more stories. 7 o'clock? Technically still 7 o'clock. Right, here we go. Oh, actually, that moves nicely onto this one. Nights out to lights out in Cyprus. So in our late teens, me and Neil spent a lot of time together. Not only we were superstar salesmen at MFI, we also spent every Friday and Saturday night together hitting the towns of Kent, along with Paul, Trev, Nick, Gary and Rob. We would head out for nights of drinking, dancing. I can't say pulling, but that didn't work. But where Neil was no good at pulling, his strength excelled at drinking. One story comes to mind in particular. Board at Lager, WKD, Smirnoff Ice, BK Blue. Me and Neil set ourselves a challenge. Drink every spirit in the bar with Coke. So vodka, rum, whiskey, brandy, Tia Maria, Cinzano, even gin, we did them all. We were left with one bottle, Baileys. Delicious Baileys and Coke. After a small argument with a barman who refused to serve us, we won and a new drink was born. A delicious Baileys and Coke. Neil being Neil, following on what Paul said, thinking he's a big man, I can drink anything. Everything's good for me. Great. Bought him a nice, delicious Baileys and Coke. Neil's words? Oh, this is actually quite nice. So in honour of that, Neil, I bought you a little present. This wasn't meant to be a toast moment, obviously, but if we can all give a toast to Neil. Come on, Neil, drink it up, mate.
Nice.
Yes, actually, yeah. The words were said. It was actually nice. So, here's to the groom. Here you go, Neil. Bit more, Neil, bit more. Nice? Yeah, all right. A little bit more coke in there, mate. You might just shit up it.
This is new cruise.
Yeah, it's COVID.
Still quite nice, though, is it?
Yeah, that's
it. Anyway. We'll carry on. So, the night's carried on. Drinking, dancing. Still not very hot, obviously. But now, this is when Neil went to one of the darkest periods of his life. I'm now sorry. The night should start off as normal. A few drinks, a couple of Baileys and Cokes. But this wasn't enough for anyone. Neil needed more. Neil needed his fix. Nicky? I'm sorry to bring this up, man. It needs to be said. Neil had a dirty secret. An addiction. Neil, or Zamo, as he was called, would slip off into the night looking to fill his empty space. We tried our best, didn't we, Neil? We tried our best. We just wouldn't listen. Neil was sick. It's all going to a head in that holiday in Iron Upper. I came home after a night out and found Neil collapsed on the apartment floor, spoon in one hand and the deadly white stuff in the other. That was the night I knew we had to do something to put a stop to it. Neil had to face up, you know. He was addicted. He had an illness. He was addicted to coleslaw. He couldn't get enough of it. Every night, he would slip off into the night looking for a kebab shop, coleslaw. Extra coleslaw. Extra coleslaw. And then we went and took him to Cyprus. He was like a kid in a sweet shop. We lost him. But standing here today now, after 40 years, I know I can put that down in front of you.
I'm
going to
touch it.
And it'll be fine. We worked together, Neil, didn't we? You know, with the help of potato salad, hummus, even salad cream. We got through it, didn't we? And then Neil had a life-changing moment. Right at the right time. Demi was born. And Neil knew he had to put that behind us. He had to move on. Thank God, Neil. We got through it. We're just going to go. So, right, we're going to have to move on because we're losing time. Seven, definitely seven. Right. Steve Cram Schultz.
Oh, Steve Schultz has got a lot of the crams.
Neil's hard tackle.
It's
a kind of magic.
Right, it's a kind of magic. Right, for those of you who don't know, our stag do was an 80s weekender at Costa Pelt Bognor. probably about a month or so now. I'm not going to disclose too much of that. I know there's a couple of the stag gentlemen out today, Bailey Jack as well, and obviously Trev as well, mainly for legal reasons, supposedly. But we took the decision to choose Neil's evening attire for him. Now, obviously he didn't know this, so we eased him in gently. So the Friday night was... there was a lot of nightclub, to be fair, and I've known Neil, again, a long time, and he weren't an image that I ever sort of wanted to see. He's also like Mr. Motivator crossed with a Pat Sharp. Now, we do have the photos. We haven't printed them out. Again, if you don't want them to get into the wrong hands, if you do want to see the photos of Neil dressed up as, a weird PE instructor, which you wouldn't want to leave in your school, then please come see me or James. Saturday night was, Freddie Mercury in drag. I can't remember the name of the song, but it was a black leather skirt. I want to break free. Pink top. And we had some difficulties with the props. Unfortunately, Amazon didn't quite deliver in time, and that ended up, I believe, in James and Trev walking through Bognor in a lot of the charity shops. We purchased a bra, which was the front clipping bra, which got all of us really, to be fair. We're bad enough for the back ones, and the front ones just done us all in. But lucky, we didn't need any padding, so lucky it was in that sort of shape at the moment. And then we stumbled after the length of Brentford Bognor onto, I think it's the second to last charity shop, to buy a Hoover. I'm sure if you remember that video with the Hoover. Now, I didn't believe we were going to get one, and then my friend, who's actually not here at the moment, turned around and said, James has just got one, and he was a really good retro Hoover, and I think the climax was when the really lovely lady that sold us to it said, it's actually got a 3-month guarantee, and it's working, and it comes in 3 Hoover bags. Well, it did work, because we plugged it in and almost strangled half the people in the club, because you were hoovering while people were dancing. And obviously Neil being Neil, he went in quite hard on the Friday night as Neil does, and on the Saturday night as well. But by Sunday, I think the exertion caught up with him, and he was tucked up snoozing by about 10 o'clock. It was a fantastic fantastic stag do. Again, we've got the pictures. If you want to see them, please come and see us, because they are. They are on our phones, and right, So just before we finish the final sentence, again, I've touched on before, it is a great honour. I know, obviously, massive amount of friendship as well. It's been through some really good stuff and some not so great stuff, but we're still here after 42, 43 years together. So I know I've mentioned, but I would like to raise a toast, please, to Mr. and Mrs. Williams. Thank you.
Just a small little thing that we're trying to work out how to end this, and I think Nick might join in and Trev might join in this. We want to honour this to Mr. Mark Williams with a night in Neil's house where we thought Mark was out, we'd be honest. We trundled in at 2 a.m. or whatever it was. And yeah, you know, Dad's out, it's fine, stick on some records and we'll just play loud music. We spoke to Mark about it, he doesn't remember this, but we still remember and we still talk about it. So the way to end this speech was Mark Williams kicking in the door, which definitely did happen, but we went, and the line of, that's it kids, party's over.
Thank you, legend.
Thank you everyone for coming. Mum, you look lovely, honestly. I had to hold back a few tears in the little hall. Neil, you look good as well. I can't miss you that. But yeah, honestly, I hope you do have the best honeymoon. You've had a brilliant day today. Beautiful day. And yeah, thank you everybody for coming.
Well done. Cheers. Good boy.
I just want to say thank you ever so much, everyone, for coming and supporting Nicky and Neil today. Never thought I'd really be speechless, but I actually feel like I am. And the only thing more beautiful than Nicky's dress is her smile today. And she's been so happy. And Neil, I just want to say, well done. Thank you for making my mate the happiest Mrs. Williams there is. Thank you. Mr. and Mrs. Williams, can you raise your glasses? Thank you. Right. It's took 50 years to get someone to marry my sis. Now the rings are on and you've sealed it with a kiss. Sorry, Neil, there's no returns on this one. She's yours for good and the deal is done. Going to Nikki's dinner is one of my favourite things to do. So it's great that she's married someone who can also cook too. They say marriage grows better with time, a bit like Nikki's favourite thing, wine. A couple who love adventures and rye, their cat Marmite and some home DIY. Who would have thought it started just as a roommate, resulting in buying a house and setting a wedding date? So here's to the next chapter, the best yet, a special day you both will never forget. I wish you many years of happy married life as Mr. and Mrs. Williams, the new husband and wife.
Food is at the back, fill your bellies, and once we've eaten, we're going to clear away most of the tables or just pull the curtain across, and we're going to try and go out there, have some drinks, be in the garden, and just enjoy ourselves, basically. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much, everyone.
Oh, that's a good way. Yeah, she was a preacher. Thank you.
through the ages just like wine. Quiet thoughts come floating down and settle softly to the ground like gold of autumn leaves around my feet. I touch them and they burst apart with sweet memories. Memories of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories pressed between the pages of my mind. Memories sweetened through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories pressed between the pages of my mind. Memories sweetened through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories, sweet memories, memories pressed between the pages of my mind. Memories sweetened through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories, sweet memories, memories.